So if you are a shareholder of Palantir stock, you may have noticed that the stock is down double-digit percent today, and there's good reason for this. And if you're not really sure what's going on, you know, you're considering selling out, or you're kind of freaking out because maybe you're down quite significantly on your account, hold on, I'm going to provide you some information in this video, so you want to watch it all the way through. And maybe it'll give you some clarity as to why the stock is down, what could be happening right now, especially over the short term with Palantir stock, and where this could go from here. So if you didn't know, this morning Palantir actually reported their earnings and they were really good. We're gonna go through all of those numbers. They were really good. And I'm gonna say this right off the bat. You may know from my previous videos that I'm not a huge fan of Palantir stock because of a few reasons like valuation. But I'm a huge fan of Palantir, the business. I think the business is phenomenal. The technology they have is phenomenal. So please, if you're gonna comment down below and say, oh, he's a Palantir bear and all this stuff, just save it. I mean, you could comment it for the YouTube algorithm. That helps out a ton. But I am not short Palantir. I've never been short Palantir. I don't own puts or anything like that in Palantir. I actually have never opened any position long or short in Palantir stock. So full disclosure, full transparency for you guys. But anyways, after all of this, am I interested in buying? Not quite yet, but it's starting to get there. This dip today is definitely one that caught my attention. And when I go through the numbers, you know, it may make it clear as to why the stock is suffering the way it is. And I'll also kind of quickly touch upon why it's starting to interest me. But anyways, guys, if you enjoy this video, smash the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and let's get into it. So let's start off with their earnings numbers, which again, were objectively really good. EPS beat by 6 cents, although they did still lose money in the quarter, which is fine. They're a high growth company. That is to be expected. Revenue beat by $21 million, but what's more interesting is the growth of this revenue, which was 40% year over year. In summary here, they say that during Q4, they signed 21 contracts worth $5 million each, and that includes 12 of them, which are worth $10 million each. This resulted in their overall 2020 fiscal year to come in at 47% revenue growth year over year and 17% adjusted operating margin. So this is a very strong showing here from Palantir stock. Now I'm gonna iterate this again because I get these comments all the time when I talk about Palantir. I love the business. When you see numbers like this, this shows that the business is phenomenal. They're growing extremely fast. They're clearly doing things right. And this is definitely a stock that I will want to own one day. And you can see that with Apollo, which is their continuous delivery software, which powers their SaaS platforms, they are in a league of their own, and this is remarkable. And guys, working for Palantir, I've watched a few videos on interviews, people's experiences with that. If you work at Palantir, it's seen as prestigious. This company has a very, very high bar. It's not like working at any of the other big tech companies like Facebook or Google, which, you know, there's a lot of people working there, so it's not like you're an exclusive club. But if you're working at Palantir, you are seen as someone that is highly intelligent. And that alone speaks volumes. They attract super talented people, and that's the kind of business that I would want to own as an investment. That being said, this is an investment channel. This is not a let's throw our money out there and gamble and see how things do channel. No, no, no. We actually look at fundamentals on this channel. And the fundamentals, in my opinion, just couldn't justify the valuation, which is why the stock is selling off today. Now, there are tons of YouTubers that are going to disagree with me. Some of them may even be bigger channels that, you know, they're bullish on Palantir. And I respect every opinion. I respect every perspective. And who knows, I may end up being dead wrong on this stock, but I'm gonna stand by what I said before. I still think that Palantir is an expensive stock, even after the sell-off. I think it is expensive. I've said this previously before, it's an expensive stock, and finally investors are starting to realize this, and that's pulled down valuations at least a little bit, which is good. In fact, even after today's 12.79% drop, the valuation of Palantir is $52 billion. So I want to look deeper now to see what they have that can justify this. So I went through their earnings report, and here's what I kind of took out of that and want to share with you. So here's an image of their revenue growth, and the reason I keep coming back to this is because this is one of the biggest bull theses that I hear all over the internet for owning Palantir stock. Revenue growth is great, but when your valuation is out of whack, when you're pulling in, you know, a billion, couple billion dollars, and your valuation is, $50, $60, $70 billion, there is a disconnect there, and eventually investors do get scared at the first sign of slowdown. But the issue with Palantir may not just be a slowdown. We will talk about that in a second, but let's just go through the numbers first here. Q4, year-over-year, up 40%. Fiscal year 2020, year-over-year, up 47%. We talked about this. Digging deeper, average revenue per customer was up 41% year-over-year. And if you look at just the top 20 customers, this number is actually up 34% year-over-year. And this tells me that their large customers are paying even more for their products and their services, implying that they love their products. Now, I did a bit of digging and I found a report from an analyst, a quote really, that kind of summarized what led to some of the selling today. Now, next year, Palantir expects to grow their revenue by over 30%. So this is strong, but in 2020, they grew it by 47%. So this shows us that growth is actually most likely going to slow down next year. Still very strong, don't get me wrong. It's still incredible growth, still better than many, many, many companies out there. But the market was expecting something like 40% plus or 50% plus growth to justify the valuation and the run-up that the stock has had. And bottom line, we did not get that. We got 30% plus expected for next year. The market saw that as a miss, if you will, and sold off. An analyst here actually states that 40% growth was expected for valuations with Palantir to kind of justify where it's going and if it can keep this momentum up. And since they didn't deliver, investors sold out. Then to add fuel to the fire, we got lockups expiring in the stock here very soon, where 80% of the total shares will be unlocked in 3 trading days. The lockup hasn't even hit us yet, but the stock is already going down. So I expect more selling pressure for Palantir this week. I expect this stock to probably have one of its worst weeks ever, if not the worst week ever, because there's just so much negativity and a lot of selling pressure, which leads to lower prices. That's the bottom line. But that's not necessarily a bad thing for long-term investors. We'll get into that in a second. But what I do want to really talk about before I talk about the outlook for the stock here after this sell-off is I want to address another huge bullish point, which seems to be all over the comment section. Whenever I talk about Palantir, this is probably the most common comment that I see. And that is that Palantir is huge in government. They're number one in government. This is a government play. The reality is, though, that government contracts only make up a little over half of Palantir's revenue. So guess what? While everyone seems to think that government is such a massive, massive part of this business, it is technically slightly over majority. The reality is that they get pretty much half of their revenues from, you know, companies, corporations. You know, PG&E was one of the companies I believe they signed up recently, and there's a bunch of others as well. You know, they work with a lot of corporations as well. So to say that this is a pure play government exposure type company is not true. It's far from it. Only half of their revenues come from government. Just remember that. Now, the problem that I see is that, you know, in the government space, these guys are dominating. Palantir is a leader. Palantir is a head of the pack. There's, you know, barely any companies that can really compete with them even on this scale. So I think that they can really have a foothold on that market if they don't already have it today. But when it comes to their commercial side or the corporation side of their business where they sell to businesses, that is where they're gonna see a lot of competition in my opinion. They won't be able to justify the super high price tags if there are other companies that are able to offer 90% of the offering for, you know, 20-30% less cost. Just think about it. These corporations, they're looking for a balance between security and value and productivity increases and the cost that they have to pay. If you go up to a company and say, hey, you can pay this much money and increase your productivity by this much, or you can pay this much money and increase your productivity by this much, just a little bit less, guess which one they're gonna pick? More often than not, businesses are going to go with the most financially best decision for them. So a bottom line really for this topic is that government, I think Palantir is gonna just keep winning there. But when it comes to their commercial side of the business, I think there's gonna be a lot of competition that they're gonna face. So now let's get into the actual stock movement today. The stock dropped quite a bit. The charts are starting to look interesting, is this a buying opportunity? Well, here's the thing. For me, I'm gonna let the dust settle. Like I said, I think this week is gonna add a lot more selling pressure in Palantir. I'm in no rush to buy in at these valuations. $50 billion, you gotta be kidding me. There's no way I'm buying in at this price. But, you know, if the selling pressure continues, lockups open, people start selling, more and more negativity comes out, this could see $40, $30 billion valuation in fairly short order. That's when it may start getting more attractive to me. The technicals on the charts here show us that the stock is actually at a key support level right now. And we also seem to be showing oversold levels on the stochastics. So, I mean, you would look at this and think, okay, this seems to be oversold. It should reverse and start moving higher. But if you look at the external factors, like what we talked about, you know, lockups expiring, negativity, press all around the stock right now, it didn't really meet guidance expectations for next year, it could still stay oversold and go down to the low 20s before we find a true bottom. That's just my two cents. I love using technicals, but I'm never just gonna look at the technicals, ignore the fundamentals, and buy into a stock. I'm gonna consider both, and when both those things align, those are typically my best investment opportunities. But anyways, if you guys are in Palantir stock, don't panic. Going into the stock, you know this is a highly volatile stock. It's at a hugely lofty premium valuation. And you're pretty much paying for that. Very few investors got into this at like $10 a share, which was a steal in hindsight. I don't think we're gonna get back down there. But a lot of investors got in at like, you know, the high 30s and close to $40. And if that was you, you should be loving this dip right now, because if nothing changed with what they reported, if things are still looking good to you, that is the definition of a buying opportunity. Buy the dip, you know, the saying, buy the dip. This is an example of buy the dip if that's your situation. But anyways, for me guys, like I said, I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna sit this one back. Maybe we'll make an update video next week on the stock, see how things play out. Let me know if you wanna see that. But I hope this video kind of provided you some insight as to what's going on, why the stock sold off, a couple of things that are still happening around the business that could lead to more selling pressure very soon. And hopefully this helps you prepare yourself and kind of calms you down a bit and not kind of panic just because the stock is down here today. Anyways, thank you so much for your support, guys. Drop a like, subscribe down below. But either way, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to invest positively, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.